After years and years of searching, I've finally got my hands on my holy grail plant, and I'll be showing it to you guys shortly. I've been keeping planted tanks for almost 10 years now, and the goal of this channel is to take you along with me on my planted tank journey, as well as teaching you the tips and tricks I wish I had learned a lot earlier in this hobby. So today I'm super excited because we're going to be walking around and looking at my collection of rare aquarium plants that I've collected over the years, and I've got quite the collection by now, and I'm super, super proud of it. And at the end, I'm gonna reveal this holy grail plant that I've probably been searching for the past 5 years at least. I saw this plant way back and I was absolutely blown away. I almost ordered it in from some place in Indonesia for $120, which would have been ridiculous because that wasn't even with the shipping. But long story short, I've been after this plant for a really long time and I am so excited to finally get my hands on it. So I live in Canada, and unfortunately the hobby over here isn't quite as advanced as other places of the world, like the United States or EU, or even like the rare plant scene over in Singapore and Indonesia. Over there is just crazy. What I have isn't going to be anything compared to what some of those guys have. But nonetheless, I'm still really proud of my rare plant collection, and I think a lot of people will find it interesting, and they'll see some plants they've never seen before. So without further ado, let's go take a peek at some of my rarest plants in my collection. Let's start off with this tank right beside me. This is my best tank for growing plants. If I have a species that's difficult to grow or I'm struggling with and I want to keep it, I have to throw it in here, and usually when I do, they start doing good. It's got two rather rare plants and two of my most difficult. The first one is Rotala telenodensis. This is an absolutely stunning plant, but it's very hard to grow. It's very similar to Rotala bonsai, kind of looks like a bigger version with bigger leaves. If you've ever grown Rotala macrandra, it's very similar, except it's a bit harder. It's a lot pickier, it stunts a lot easier, it shades itself out, and it likes to get really, really dense and send out all these side shoots, which are just impossible to keep up with. Basically, it's not fun to deal with, but it's a super stunning plant, so I absolutely love it. In this tank, we also have Hygrophila or Hygrophila chai, which is a mutated version of Hygrophila araguaia. I tried this plant in the past in my Dutch style aquascape and it got shaded out for literally like a week and then completely melted away and died, which was super unfortunate, and I was super sad to lose it because I spent a long time trying to find it. But I finally have it again and it's growing super well, and it's really thriving in this scape. Now we'll move to the other tank right beside me on my other side that has a lot of rare plants as well. In this tank, we have a ton of really rare epiphyte plants, which means they attach to wood, rocks, or other decorations in the tank. A couple of the most noticeable are these different species of purple Buccephalandra. I get a ton of questions about these guys, so I'm gonna walk you guys through and tell you basically what's what. First off, we have the most abundant, which is Buccephalandra helena 2013. It's got these dark blue to pink to purple leaves that are in the shape of little tears. They're super big leaves, but super, super beautiful. It's stupid pretty and one of my favorites of all the Buccephalandra I keep. I'm having a little bit of issues with nutrient deficiencies right now, so some of the newest leaves don't look their best, but when this plant is doing good and healthy, these will come in a vibrant, bright pink color. Down in the carpet, we have Buccephalandra Purple Mini Phantom, and this is a tiny buce and absolutely stunning. I love this small leaf shape and the bright purple color this stuff gets as well. I'd almost completely lost this species a while back. I only had a single leaf that had disappeared in my tanks. It got lost in the stem. I thought it was gone for good, but a couple months later I found it starting to grow back, and this is about a year's worth of growth from almost nothing. Some of these buces are unfortunately harder to get a good shot of than others. This one is Buccephalandra Paris, which has dark green leaves, but the new ones are this nice pink to orange color, and I think it's going to get some pretty big leaves later on as it gets older. I haven't had this one for long, and I'm excited to see what it turns into. Towards the back, there's two more rare plant species. One of these is another purple Buccephalandra, this one being Buccephalandra Neo Elephant. It's got a nice deep purple, but the new leaves are the most intense. It's like a bright hot pink to hot, like neon orange. It's an absolutely crazy plant, and I always love when it puts out new leaves. And then even behind that, further towards the back, I have Anubias Broad White. It's kind of like Anubias Pinto, which has a mix of green and white leaves, but for this one, the new leaves are almost completely white, which is super pretty. So that's everything in this tank behind me, and now we're gonna go look at my 24-gallon Dutch style aquascape. This is a brand new tank and I'm super excited to show it to you guys, but I'm not going to yet today. It's a couple of weeks or months old by now, but I've been working on this big video where I'm documenting from the start all the way through, showing all the different steps and the progress of this tank, and I don't want to spoil that. So I'm going to show you a couple of the rare plants in it, but I don't want to give away the whole scape and show you guys everything. So it's just going to be little snippets of a couple of the rare plants in there. Now I want to give a huge shout out to Aquaflora Canada, who sent me some really cool rare plants for this tank. There's going to be a link below, a Linktree link, with a discount code to Aquaflora Canada. When you use this, a little bit goes back to me, and I use that money to put towards making new scapes and bringing more content to you guys. The first plant I got from these guys was Kabamba furcata. It's this super pretty purplish pink plant, very fluffy, and I'm having a lot of fun learning about it. It was struggling a little bit at the beginning and I honestly didn't know much about it, but now it seems to be doing a lot better. It's a pretty slow grower compared to, you know, normal Kabamba, but it's a beautiful plant. We also got from Aquaflora Canada, Ludwigia White, which is such a stunning plant and has been on my list for a super long time. It pops so much in a planted aquarium and there's nothing else like it that will be that size and create that beautiful white color. And I'm super thankful for a company to be bringing in rare plants like this, especially to Canada where it's a lot harder to get things like this. And I'm super happy to have them in my tank now. Then finally in this tank, we have what's probably my most expensive and most rare plant. And this is Buccifalandra Ghost 2011, which is unfortunately covered, absolutely covered in black beard algae. I had a problem with things melting and it being a new tank and all these organics built up and it's just looking pretty rough, but I have no doubt I won't be able to bounce back and get it looking good again once this tank matures a bit. If you look past all this algae, you can see that the older leaves are this beautiful deep purple color and the new ones come in and sometimes this bright red, which is absolutely stunning and there's nothing else like it in the hobby. One thing you may have noticed is a couple of these Buccifalandras I've talked about have numbers at the end of them. And what does that mean? The ones I'm talking about specifically are Buccifalandra Ghost 2011 and Buccifalandra Helena 2013. Now there's a bunch more different species of Buce that have these numbers at the end of them, which represent the year they were harvested in. A lot of these plants were in high demand in the early 2010s and they come from little islands all along Borneo. What was happening was all these farmers were getting paid a ton of money by places in Vietnam and China and in Indonesia and Singapore and in the United States. They were paying all these farmers in this third world country lots of money for these beautiful Buccifalandra plants for the aquarium hobby. And what happened was they were going out to these small offskirt islands looking for different Buccifalandra and found some beautiful ones in tiny little patches and harvested them all up. Now what happened with these Buce 2011 and Helena 2013 is some crazy mutation had occurred that gave it this crazy color, and unfortunately they harvested it all and they haven't been able to find these in the wild since. They think the species have been wiped out and they are only available and maintained throughout the aquarium trade now. It's unfortunate to think about that these plants aren't around in the wild anymore, but it's nice that they are maintained through the aquarium trade, and it's not like we could go out and replant them in the exact environment they came from because it's so convoluted. We don't know who harvested them and where exactly they harvested them, so it's not like you're reintroducing them to your natural environment. You're just kind of placing them back in the wild and seeing what happens. I kind of went on a tangent there. You still haven't seen my Holy Grail plants. This was one that probably started my interest in the rare plant aspect of the hobby and one of the first I discovered, and I'm super happy that Aquascape Room Canada brought it in and I finally got my hands on this stuff. This is Cryptocorn Tiger Spiralis. It's a tall, beautiful, truly red crypt that will get these crazy striations under high light and good conditions once it's established. No, currently, it doesn't look like much, and will probably melt away, but we're going to put it in this tank to give it the best chance of success, and once it's grown out, we'll move it to a different scape and find a more permanent solution, because it's going to get way too big for this little tank. I'll continue to update you guys, of course, on how this plant develops and grows out. I'm super excited to see how it does, but that about wraps it up. Let me know down below in the comments, what is your prized possession in your aquarium plant collection? I'd love to know. I always love learning about new rare plants. But anyways guys, that was Kim's Fish Tanks. Thank you so much for watching. Peace.